those are the areas. I thought I'd start off with where are we right now. So this is a typical week of earthquakes in Hawaii, and this is what happened last week, 400-something earthquakes on the island. The ones that are labeled are ones people felt, or at least reported felt, and you can see they occur mostly on Kilauea and Mauna Loa, some scattered around in the north part of the island as well. These are cross sections in depth going north, south, and east, west, if you want to know what it looks like underground. So that's the typical week, 400-something, 500 earthquakes. Multiply that by four, and you get about 1,500 to 2,000 a month. So if we go back in time in our earthquake catalog, all the way back to 1959, you can see we're pretty consistent. There's some ups and downs, but it's always around that number per month, okay? But look at this, what's going on here. So this was the 2018 eruption. This is what was so unusual about that eruption. It's never been, that amount of earthquakes has never been measured before in Hawaii, 20 times higher than the normal rate. And another thing, I'll zoom in on that a little bit. So here we are, here's that eruption. Remember I said it was 3 years of earthquakes in 3 months. Here they are, May, June, and July mostly. Also August right there. One thing to note is that the level of earthquake activity right now, as measured by the counts, this is again per month, is about twice as much as it was before the eruption. So the volcano is still settling, it's still adjusting, and that's producing earthquakes still to this day. So the aftershocks were very plentiful and are continuing to this day to a certain degree. And you can see just by eye, these are all the larger ones, magnitude 2.7 and higher, that occurred during the first month or two after the earthquake. And again, there's that elliptical area that you can see quite clearly. This is interpreted as the toe of that area of the fault that's pushing its way toward seaward along that boundary between the two materials under the ocean. And let's see, what else can we say about it? It spans about 435 miles. Now, one of the other models of slip is shown here, which also agrees roughly with where the earthquakes occurred. So we think there was about 5 meters of movement of the flank of the volcano during the earthquake alone. And this is just the summary of that sequence. So you had the 6.9, the decay down, just kind of a nice decay down, and then, but remember, I told you that the activity is elevated now compared to what it was before. See how before we were getting maybe 100 earthquakes per week, and now we're getting about 200 earthquakes per week. And that's because that south flank of the volcano is still very mobile compared to what it was before. It's still wanting to slide, it's still settling, and it's producing more earthquakes than it would otherwise. So we have lots of earthquakes still occurring, but in the usual places, at the summit of Kilauea, the summit of Mauna Loa, the south flank that I've talked about in this area, the deep Pahala zone, the deep lower southwest rift as it's known. I show this plot down here. This is showing the last week of the eruption, when some 2,500 earthquakes happened, compared to now. So all the variation we've had in the year and a half since then has been pretty consistent compared to then. So steady as she goes is what's happening now. The volcano is adjusting to its new normal, but it's not changing very rapidly necessarily. It's reached a new normal for now. So why was the seismicity rate so high? Well, there was an eruption, and it was the biggest eruption in 200 years. And this eruption involved both the summit and the flank. A lot was going on, it made a lot of earthquakes. That's the simple answer. What type of processes contributed to that high rate? Well, the three we talked about, that migration of magma, you know, cutting its way down to lower east rift zone, the 6.9 earthquake, and of course the caldera collapse. And finally, why is the rate still a little bit higher now? It's because the volcano is still pretty mobile. The south flank is still moving at a higher rate than usual. There are still aftershocks happening along that fault, and there will be for quite some time.